For those that are new, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and turn on all notifications to be notified whenever a brand new video is posted onto this channel. Thank you all so much for your continued support. Now let's begin. With the Avengers 4 movie on the horizon, fans within the Marvel Cinematic Universe are begging the question as to what the role of the Hulk is going to be as we go into the Avengers 4 movie. Now with the film having to drop in just about 11 months from now, we do have leaked photos of the set and which showcases Steve Rogers, Tony Stark, and of course Bruce Banner, alongside several other heroes having to make a very interesting appearance, different than what we saw in Avengers Infinity War, at least in terms of appearance. One particular character in which we are going to be discussing that having to be Bruce Banner, aka the Hulk. Now in Avengers Infinity War, it was blatantly obvious that Thanos had not only outmatched Hulk in terms of feats, but also having to beat him down severely enough to where it forced Hulk never to manifest himself onto the surface due to the end result of Hulk having to be fearful of what Thanos can do. That was made painfully evident as we saw Bruce Banner continuously ask the Hulk to reappear and manifest himself on the surface, with Hulk having to reply in saying no. Now of course we do understand based on Thor Ragnarok that Bruce Banner had been the Hulk for quite some time, just about 2 years or so, in having to remain in the Hulk form for such a long time that it begs the question, can the Hulk even reappear to begin with? However, we see based on the Avengers 4 set leak photos that Bruce Banner seems to be carrying around a stick. Now this is assumingly so that based on time travel, since the movie will of course add in time travel, based on time travel having to be a huge factor in Avengers 4, the theory here is that perhaps with the manipulation of time travel, perhaps maybe we're going to be visiting the quantum universe, or maybe a different multiverse entirely, which showcases a different Bruce Banner and a different Hulk in a different timeline. And that's only based off of Bruce Banner having to carry around this stick. Of course, he's under the suit, which means that this will be full-blown green screen, so this may indicate that we might for the first time be seeing a homeless Hulk be shown on screen. And this could be as a result of a different timeline having to be dove into by Tony Stark and his friends, or maybe what we're seeing there is the end of the Hulk, the end of the Avengers movie, as Hulk grabs his belongings and going out and fading out into the distance until he's needed again once more for a future film. And now, this movie could take the plot direction and what they're going to be doing with Hulk and some of the other characters, but the Hulk, I believe, is going to be the centerpiece of the Avengers 4 movie because we didn't see Hulk in action during Infinity War. Now, I understand a lot of people may be very upset at the idea that Bruce Banner was trying to get the Hulk to manifest himself but couldn't. I think that something big needs to happen. Something life-changing needs to happen before Bruce Banner's eyes that can allow the Hulk to manifest himself onto the surface in seeing him fight Thanos. Now, if this is an alternate version of the Hulk based on time travel, then it could prove to be useful, especially now in the real world in the present time, Bruce Banner can't get the Hulk to manifest himself onto the surface. Now for them to get another Bruce Banner, another Hulk from a different timeline, and helping them and assisting them to fight Thanos wouldn't be too far-fetched of an idea based on the only fact that we have, which is we know that time travel is going to be involved, but are they going to be grabbing different characters from different timelines? That is actually backed up by some of the leaked photos that we saw on set, with Chris Evans's character having to play an early Captain America. We see the long-haired Thor. So there are different versions of different characters, perhaps maybe even going as far back and tapping into flashbacks and having to revisit some of the original history of some of these characters. The Hulk, I do believe, is going to be one of them. Now, having a Hobo Hulk appear and what this may mean after, I do believe that this could go in another direction to where either Hulk failed, he's grabbing his belongings, and he's trying to be left alone. However, also this begs the question, what if something happens to Bruce Banner that triggers the Hulk in re-emerging but can't seem to control the Hulk once he re-emerges, i.e. Worldbreaker Hulk? Now, if Worldbreaker Hulk were to appear in the film, something significant of such importance has to happen for that to even be conceived on screen. Based on the comics alone, we saw how the Hulk had underwent such pain and such much loss in his life that it ultimately triggered him in not only having to fight the Illuminati and Doctor Strange, but also triggering a power that is seemingly unstoppable. Now, of course, the argument can be made, and surely is debatable, on whether or not Worldbreaker Hulk can even contest against Thanos with the Infinity Gauntlet. Of course, that debate in and of itself will be saved for a different time. However, I do feel as if it's going to be a very interesting idea in seeing what the Hulk is going to do, especially when going up against Thanos now that we see him holding all six of the Infinity Stones. Now, this could always go back and time can be reversed to where perhaps maybe they all gather together, different versions of the characters, to where they all meet up at the final battle at Wakanda, where they can finally catch Thanos based on their time traveling asset and having to stop him there from collecting the Mind Stone. Anything can happen, but I do feel as if a homeless hobo Hulk could work. But then again, the Hulk character is part owned by Universal and not fully Marvel, so this could be the ultimate write-off in writing off Hulk's character for the foreseeable future. Of course, I can only see them doing some sort of a time jump and seeing what could happen 5-10 years into the future, in the idea that Bruce Banner's character had survived and the Hulk is still there, but he's been on the run, he's been homeless because of the fact that he's been so terrified on fighting Thanos, which could ultimately make sense. And there you go, there's the idea that the Hulk character could go in one of many directions. Now, I don't think personally this is going to be the last time we ever see the end of the Hulk in the MCU. Just because he is owned partly by Universal and not fully by Marvel doesn't mean that this is going to be the end of the Hulk. And I do believe that for the foreseeable future, they could always introduce more from the Hulk, introducing Red Hulk, introducing Worldbreaker Hulk, which I do believe would be awesome to see in this film with the Avengers 4. But since you need powerful warriors, since you need powerful characters to go up against Thanos now that he has all six of the Infinity Stones, what better way to have Hulk reemerge, either A, as homeless Hulk, B, as Worldbreaker Hulk, or C, having him just be enraged Hulk and just have him battle Thanos from then on in. So with Bruce Banner and the Hulk having to remain at the end of Infinity War, there's no doubt that the Hulk is going to be in action again, but the question begs, is the Hulk going to do a better job than how he first did against Thanos, which can be arguable, because if Thanos still has the gauntlet despite what kind of condition it's in, then Thanos can easily stomp. We saw Thanos just completely stomp out Hulk, but since the gauntlet is damaged, and since there's no more room for Thanos to fully possibly even use the gauntlet, he's vulnerable. Is he strong? Absolutely, but he's still vulnerable. But despite all reports, I do believe that the homeless Hulk concept was originated in Thor Ragnarok, so unless they plan on doing some sort of a time jump, or they introduce a different Bruce Banner from a different universe, that could always work. Even though we still have the current Bruce Banner now, they can always change up the directions, because there are lots of things right now that Avengers 4 is setting itself up for that don't make any sense. We see different characters that are still alive that seem to be returning. We see an older version of Captain America. We see the older Thor. So there's so many different variations of characters appearing that it could either be a flashback, it can either be kind of like a setback to where they revisit the past and trying to get those characters to join. Of course, we know Captain Marvel is going to be a part of the big fight, but the only other character that's not going to be involved is going to be Adam Warlock, because he will be saved for Guardians of the Galaxy 3. So for Hulk, I do think that if they don't manage to get him out regularly, then I do think that what's closest to Bruce Banner needs to be thrown away, and that's Black Widow. If Black Widow ends up dying in Avengers 4, that would be such a significant impact on Bruce Banner's character that it would only drive him insane to see the one person that he loved just get completely crushed before his very eyes. Then at that point, we can see Hulk reemerge. We can also take into consideration that they could always bring in a merged Hulk or Professor Hulk, which not a lot of people actually know about, but they can always introduce those variations of Hulk into the film for the very first time, which was kind of alluded back in Thor Ragnarok when they spoke about, you know, Bruce Banner having to be the Hulk for such a long time. Now, with the concept of the merged Hulk, is the merged intelligence of Bruce Banner having to be put together with the brute strength of Hulk. Now, this Hulk would be undoubtedly one of the most dangerous versions of who the Hulk character is, just because You have the intelligence of Bruce Banner, and you have the raw, unmitigated power of the Gray Hulk, the regular Green Hulk per se, because I don't think that they're going to be giving Hulk his own movie anytime soon, and it would really be awesome to see the Gray Hulk appear, which I don't think they're going to do, and Red Hulk is really up in the air right now, but I think the best thing for them to do is if they don't want to play off the homeless Hulk in the future, if they don't want to play off the idea of Worldbreaker Hulk, they could always introduce Professor Hulk or Merged Hulk with the intelligence of Bruce Banner equipped with the brute strength of the Green Hulk. So that would make for a very interesting concept, because if that were to be the case, we know that the Russo brothers have confirmed that the Hulk arc is going to end in Avengers 4. So it started during Thor Ragnarok, it went through Avengers Infinity War with Hulk having to be petrified of even fighting Thanos to begin with, and now ultimately tying in the upcoming Avengers movie and having to basically finish everything up. So in the end, guys, let me know your overall thoughts as to your concept behind the Hulk, as to which version we might end up seeing in the upcoming movie. Is it going to be Professor Hulk? Is it going to be Homeless Hulk? Is it going to be Worldbreaker Hulk? Is it going to be Gray Hulk? Is it going to be Red Hulk? Let me know in the comment section below, guys. Thank you all so much for watching. If you guys cannot wait for Avengers 4, slap a like on the video. If you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button, guys. Turn on all notifications. Tune back in for more. If you guys want to go on ahead and watch more Avengers content from me, you guys can find the official link down in the description box. Check it out, guys. Watch all of your favorite videos down below, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you guys in the next video. For me, I'm excited because I really want to see the Hulk kick Thanos' ass, because in the Avengers Infinity War movie, he was bitched out way too quick, even though it was pretty cool to see Thanos just three-piece the crap out of Hulk and beat him down. I think it did not serve the character any justice in seeing what he went through, and thus, I do hope that Hulk actually makes a huge comeback in beating Thanos up, but we're gonna have to wait and see for that. So, thank you all so much once again. Tune back in for more, and I'll be seeing you all down in the comment section below. Take it easy, guys. Peace.